बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम। इफ़ यू हैव डन एमएससी स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड वांट टू टेक एडमिशन इन एमफिल स्टैटिस्टिक्स और यू अचीव द माइलस्टोन ऑफ एमफिल स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड वांट टू डू पीएचडी स्टैटिस्टिक्स, यू विल हैव टू टेक द रिटन टेस्ट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स इन एवरी यूनिवर्सिटी। एंड इफ़ यू आर जॉबलेस एंड यू वॉन्ट टू गेट द जॉब ऑफ अ स्टैटिस्टिकल ऑफिसर, स्टैटिस्टिशियन, सब्जेक्ट स्पेशलिस्ट, स्टैटिस्टिक्स लेक्चरर और रिसर्च ऑफिसर, यू विल हैव टू पास द रिटन टेस्ट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, बीइंग अ प्रोफेसर ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह आई हैव स्टार्टेड बेसिक स्टैटिस्टिक्स कोर्स एंड टुडे इट इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 9। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडेज लेक्चर, आई रिक्वेस्ट everyone subscribe to my channel, like and share my channel and click the bell icon for the notifications of the next videos. Let's start. Question number 1 is, a distribution has variance 9. Question number 1 is, variance is given and that is equal to 9 and gamma 1 is equal to 2. Dear student, what is gamma? Gamma 1 is actually equal to beta 1 under root. Beta 1 is mu 3 square over mu 2 cube. Take the square root. It means gamma 1 will be equal to, if you will cancel the square of mu 3 with square root, that will be mu 3 over mu 2 power 3 by 2. That is the formula you will have to make your concept. Beta 1 is mu 3 square over mu 2 cube and gamma 1, which is the under root of beta 1, that will be equal to third moment about mean over mu 2 whole power 3 by 2. Gamma 1 is also given, that is 2. Just substitute. 2 is equal to mu 3 over, we know, we have learned, mu 2 is actually variance and that is 9. 9 raised to power 3 by 2, and that will be 2 is equal to mu 3 over 3 power 2. 9 can be written as 3 power 2 whole power 3 by 2. 2 will be cancelled. 3 3 is a 9, 9 3 is a 27, 27 2 is a, it means mu 3 third moment about mean is equal to 54. Variance is given and gamma 1 is given, and the question is, what is the value of the third moment about mean and also the fourth moment? Fourth moment, we know beta 2 is equal to mu 4 over mu 2 square. Beta 2 is also given and that is beta 2 is equal to 4. Just substitute. 4 is equal to mu 4 over, variance is 9, 9 square, that is 81, 81 4 is a 324 is equal to mu 4. Variance is given 9, gamma 1 is given 2 and beta 2 is given 4, and the question is, find the third and the fourth moment about mean, and the answers are 54 and 324. A very important question for all the papers of statistics. Question number 2, for a certain normal distribution, the first moment about the value 6 is 24. Actually, that is actually A. A is given. It is 6. First moment about an arbitrary origin, that is 6. And it is given 24. And the fourth moment about the value 30 is, fourth moment, it is 243. Then the coefficient of variation of the distribution is, we know coefficient of variation is always equal to s over x bar multiplied by 100. S, first moment about origin, first moment about an arbitrary origin is given. What is the formula of x bar? When any moment about any arbitrary origin is given, that will be equal to m1 prime plus a. X bar is equal to m1 prime is 24 plus a is given, that is 6. It means x bar is 30. We have calculated x bar. Now the second target is standard deviation, and for this m4 prime is given. We know in normal distribution m4 prime is always equal to 3 sigma power 4. M4 prime is 243 is equal to 3 sigma power 4. Sigma is not given, 3 will be divided over here, sigma power 4, that will be 81. 81 is equal to sigma power 4, 3 power 4 is equal to sigma power 4, and sigma will be equal to 3. Now just substitute the values of s and x bar. S is 3, x bar is 30, multiply by 100%. 3 1s are 3, 3 10s are 10, 10s are 100. Coefficient of variation will be 10%. Question number 3 is, first 4 moments about the value 7 of a distribution are, it means A is equal to 7, M1 prime is equal to 4, M2 prime is 22, M3 prime is 42, and M4 prime is equal to 52. 4 moments about A is equal to 7 are given, and the question is, then the mean is, as we have discussed in the previous question, X bar is equal to M1 prime plus A. And dear students, I want to give you one more concept. If first moment about origin is given, then that will be equal to mean. And if it is given for A, then X bar is equal to M1 prime plus A. So it is an, it has arbitrary origin, that will be 4 plus A is 7. It means X bar is equal to 11. In the paper, 11 will be the correct answer of that multiple choice question. Question number 4 is, the variance of a random variable X is 20. Question number 4, variance of a random variable X is 20. If the distribution of X is platycardic, then its fourth moment about mean is, we have to find out the fourth moment about mean. And we know in leptocardic, mesocardic and platycardic, we use beta 2 is equal to 3. And beta 2 is mu 4 over mu 2 whole square is equal to 3. M4 we have to find, and mu 2 is actually variance 20 square is equal to 3. Mu 4 is equal to 400 multiplied by 3, 1200. In platycardic, beta 2 is less than 3. It means mu 4 will be less than 1200. That will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 5. Limits of Kohl Pearson's coefficient of skewness SK are. Question number 5. Kohl Pearson's coefficient of skewness SK. Limits are SK less than equal to 3. It means minus 3 less than equal to SK less than equal to plus 3. The answer of coefficient of skewness for Kohl Pearson's will be between that interval, minus 3 to plus 3. Question number 6. For a set of observations, X bar is equal to 10. X bar mean is given, that is 10. And sigma is equal to 5. If all the observations are multiplied by 3, then the resulting mean and sigma will be. Dear students, we know X bar as well as standard deviation are affected by change of scale. If you multiply by 3, every value by 3, they both will be affected. 10 threes are, that will be 30, that will become 30, and 5 multiplied by 3, that will become 15. In the exam, X bar 30 and standard deviation 15 will be the correct option. A very important multiple choice question. Question number 7. For a distribution, beta 2 is found to be 3.5. The distribution is, we know if beta 2 is equal to 3, that is mesocardic. If beta 2 is less than 3, then it is platycardic. And if beta 2 is greater than 3 and 3.5 is more than 3, so that will be leptocardic. Leptocardic will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 8. Beta 1 coefficient of skewness and beta 2 coefficient of kurtosis are independent of. Dear students, in the last 8 lectures, I made your concept that arithmetic mean, geometric mean, harmonic mean are affected by change of origin. If you add or subtract the values, they are affected. Then we discussed measure of dispersions, range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, and interquartile range. They are affected by change of scale. If you multiply and divide every value of x by a number, they will be changed. But please keep in mind beta 1, which is coefficient of skewness, and beta 2, which is coefficient of kurtosis. They are independent of change of origin and scale. They are not affected by adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing by any number. Then which will be the correct option? Change of origin and scale. They are independent of change of origin and scale. A very important one. Question number 9. If the mean standard deviation and coefficient of skewness of a frequency distribution are, question number 9, mean is given, that is 50. Standard deviation is given, that is 40, and coefficient of skewness is given, that is minus 0.5. Respectively, the mode of the distribution, we know the formula is skewness is equal to mean minus mode over standard deviation. Just substitute the value. Skewness is minus 0.5, mean is 50, minus mode is not given, that is x over standard deviation is 40. 40 multiplied by minus 0.5 is minus 20, is equal to 50 minus x. X will be on the left side, 50 plus 20. In the paper, 70 will be the correct option. For a positively skewed distribution, dear students, we discussed in the last lecture, in the symmetric distribution, Q3 minus Q2 is equal to Q2 minus Q1. We can also say that Q3 minus Q1 is equal to 2Q2. That is the condition of symmetrical distribution. And if we have positively skewed distribution, then Q3 minus Q1 is greater than 2Q2. And in negatively skewed distribution, Q3 minus Q1 is less than Q2. So what is the question? For a positively skewed distribution, Q3 minus Q1 is greater than 2Q2. That will be the correct option in the exam. Question number 11. The movements about mean are called A part raw movements, B part movements about arbitrary origin, C central movements, D all of the above. Dear students, movements about mean are also called central movements. A very important one. Question number 12, which is the last question of today's lecture. Why it is necessary to square the differences from the mean when computing the population variance? When we are calculating variance, population variance, why we take the square of the deviations of x from their mean A part so that the extreme values will not affect the calculation, B part because it is possible that capital N could be very small, C some of the differences will be positive and some will be negative, D none of the above. C is the correct option. When we do x minus x bar, some differences are positive and some are negative. That's why we take the square whenever we compute the population variance. C will be the correct option in the exam. Assalamu alaikum.